Elton John opens a new window. Claims in his new memoir, Me, that Queen Elizabeth II opens a new window. Slapped her nephew, Viscount Linley, in front of him at a party. In an excerpt published in the Sunday Times opens a new window. On October 6, the Grammy winner writes that the British monarch, 93, had asked the son of her sister, Princess Margaret, to check on his sister, Lady Sarah Armstrong-Jones, who was feeling sick and had gone to her room to rest. After Linley, now 57, refused, the Queen lightly slapped him across the face, saying, "Don't slap, argue, slap, with, slap, me, slap, I, slap, am, slap, the Queen." John, 72, claimed the Queen saw that he had seen this exchange and simply gave him a wink and walked off. "I know the Queen's public image isn't exactly one of wild frivolity, but, in private she could be hilarious." The singer, who was knighted in 1998, was close with several members of the royal family, most notably the late Princess Diana. He wrote that Diana, who died in August 1997 at the age of 36 in a car crash in Paris, was blessed with an incredibly social ease, an ability to make people feel totally comfortable in her company. John added that Diana's sons, Prince William, opens a new window. And Prince Harry opens a new window, who she shared with ex-husband Prince Charles opens a new window, have inherited that quality from their mom. The singer and the princess met at a party in 1981, with John writing that they immediately clicked and ended up pretending to dance the Charleston while hooting at the disco's feebleness that night. "She was fabulous company, a real gossip. You could ask her anything and she'd tell you," he wrote. John, who sang Candle in the Wind at her funeral, has remained friends with William and Harry over the years. In 2018, he attended Harry's wedding to Meghan Markle opens a new window. At Windsor Castle and even performed at the lunchtime reception hosted by the Queen, playing songs including Your Song, Tiny Dancer and Circle of Life. Over the summer, his friendship with the royal couple made headlines after he defended the new parents for flying on a private jet with their newborn son. Archie opens a new window, to the Oscar winner's vacation home in Nice, France. The couple, who have been vocal about the effects of climate change, were criticized for not flying commercial. "Prince Harry's mother, Diana, Princess of Wales, was one of my dearest friends," John wrote in a series of tweets on August 19. "I feel a profound sense of obligation to protect Harry and his family from the unnecessary press intrusion that contributed to Diana's untimely death." He continued that he and his husband, David Furnish, wanted the young family to have a private holiday inside the safety and tranquility of our home after a hectic year, continuing their hard work and dedication to charity. "To maintain a high level of much-needed protection, we provided them with a private jet flight," he wrote, adding that he ensured their flight was carbon neutral, by making the appropriate contribution to carbon footprint to support Prince Harry's commitment to the environment. Earlier this year, Fabulous Digital revealed that Her Majesty giggled like a schoolgirl when she heard a rude joke about Viagra and even jokingly corrected a French royal's penis comment during a state visit. But all dirty jokes aside, the Queen reportedly showed off her wicked sense of humor when she playfully slapped her nephew at a party, according to Elton John. In his new autobiography Me, the star writes, "I know the Queen's public image isn't exactly one of wild frivolity, but in private, she could be hilarious." Recalling the baffling incident, Elton added, "I saw her approach Viscount Linley and ask him to look in on his sister, who'd been taken ill and had retired to her room." Side note: need we remind anyone that this came from a woman who keeps a slogan cushion reading "It's good to be queen" on her favorite sofa at Balmoral? Unsurprisingly, this was enough to convince a young David Armstrong Jones to call in on his sister Lady Sarah Chatto. "As he left, she saw me staring at her, gave me a wink and walked off," Elton continued. David Armstrong Jones, 57, was previously known as Viscount Linley until 2017, when he became the second Earl of Snowdon after his father passed away. The Tiny Dancer star also claims in his new autobiography that Sly Stallone and Richard Gere got into an explosive row over Princess Diana over one of his dinner parties. Elton claims that Sly had been hoping to romance the recently separated princess but was jealous by how well she got on with the pretty woman actor and challenged him to a fist fight.